You're listening to the Kristian John Thomas Show, only on Spreaker. Spreaker?
Who bloody come up with that name then?
Do you know what? I honestly do not know.
Well, it's a bloody silly name, isn't it?
Yes. Yes, it is. Spreaker! And the Kristian John Thomas Show.
That's a mouthful.
What? The John Thomas?
That was the Beatles with Drive My Car back in December of 1965. Whoa! That's a long time ago. I bet they had dinosaurs back then. Fleetwood Mac, Don't Stop.
Stop thinking about tomorrow. toy comes to life.
Oh, okay then.
Toys come to life. Just let them bloody have it. Hello, and you're listening to Radio Chris Interact, bringing you entertainment from wherever Chris Interact is at the time, and direct to where you are now, at this point, where you're listening to this very message. So, yes, welcome.
Dark. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and sell me out, and I'll lay your ship bare. See how I'll leave with every piece of you. Don't underestimate the things that I will do. There is a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark.
That was Adele with Rolling in the Deep. I once met Adele. She smelt like peanut butter. And now, it's Dr. Hook.
Sylvia's mother says Sylvia's busy. Too busy to come to the phone. Sylvia's mother says Sylvia's trying to start a new life of her own. Sylvia's mother says Sylvia's happy.
So why don't you leave her alone? And the operator says 40 cents more for the next 3 minutes, please. Says Sylvia's packing, she's gone, be leaving today. Sylvia's mother says Sylvia's marrying a fella down Galveston way. Sylvia's mother says, please don't say nothing to make her start crying and stay. And the operator says 40 cents more for the next 3 minutes, please. Says Sylvia's hurrying, she's catching the 9 o'clock train. Sylvia's mother says, take your umbrella, 'cause Sylvia, it's starting to rain. And Sylvia's mother says, thank you for calling, and sir, won't you call back again? And the operator says 40 cents more for the next 3 minutes, please.
This is Avery, I just gotta talk to her.
I'll only keep her a while.
Man, that's Sylvia's mother's one hell of a control freak.
El coche es pequeño.
La camioneta es pequeña.
You've seen that masculine words such as
coche
are
pequeño
if they're small, but feminine words such as
camioneta
are
pequeña
if they're small. The same is true with new and old.
El coche es pequeño.
La camioneta es pequeña.
El coche es nuevo.
La camioneta es nueva.
El coche es viejo.
La camioneta es vieja.
Can you hear that difference? To describe a feminine word such as
camioneta,
you use
grande,
pequeña,
nueva,
and
vieja.
But to describe a masculine word such as
coche,
you use
grande,
pequeño,
nuevo,
and
viejo.
Remember,
grande
stays the same for masculine and feminine words.
Un coche grande.
Well, that's it from us for another day. Better play us out. We've got The Ultimate Destiny. Only here. On Kristian John Thomas Radio. That's still a mouthful.
Old Godzilla was hopping around Tokyo City like a big playground when suddenly Batman burst from the shade and hit Godzilla with a bat grenade. Godzilla got pissed and began to attack, but didn't expect to be blocked by Shaq, who proceeded to open up a can of Shaq Fu when Aaron Carter came out of the blue and he started beating up Shaquille O'Neal. Then they both got flattened by the Batmobile, but before we could could make it back to the Batcave. Abraham Lincoln popped out of his grave and took an AK-47 out from under his hat. Blew Batman away with a rat-a-tat-tat, but he ran out of bullets and he ran away, because Optimus Prime came to save the day.
This is the ultimate showdown. Ultimate destiny. Good guys, bad guys, and explosions. As far as the eye can see, and only one will survive. I wonder who it will be. This is the ultimate showdown of ultimate destiny.
Godzilla took a bite out of Optimus Prime, like Scruff McGruff took a bite out of crime. And then Shaq came back covered in a tire track, but Jackie Chan jumped out and landed on his back. And Batman was injured and trying to get steady when Abraham Lincoln came back with a machete. But suddenly something caught his leg and he tripped to Indiana Jones, took him out with his whip. Then he saw Godzilla sneaking up from behind, and he reached for his gun, which he just couldn't find, cause Batman stole it and he shot and he missed, and Jackie Chan deflected it with his fist. Then he jumped in the air and he did a somersault while Abraham Lincoln tried to pull a fault on Optimus Prime, but they collided in the air. Then they both got hit by a Care Bear scare.
This is the ultimate showdown, ultimate destiny. Good guys, bad guys, and explosions. As far as the eye can see, and only one will survive. I wonder who it will be. This is the ultimate showdown.
Angels sang out in an immaculate chorus. Down from the heavens descended Chuck Norris, who delivered a kick which could shatter bones. Into the crotch of Indiana Jones, who fell over on the ground, writhing in pain, as Batman changed back into Bruce Wayne. But Chuck saw through his clever disguise, and he crushed Batman's head in between his thighs. Then Gandalf the Grey and Gandalf the White, and Monty Python and the Holy Grail's Black Knight, and Benito Mussolini and the Blue Meanie, and Cowboy Curtis and John B. the Genie, Robocop the Terminator, Captain Kirk and Darth Vader, Lo Pan, Superman, every single Power Ranger, Bill S. Preston and Theodore Logan, Spock the Rock, Doc Ock and Hulk Hogan, all came out of nowhere lightning fast, and they kicked Chuck Norris in his cowboy ass. It was the bloodiest battle that the world ever saw, with civilians looking on in total awe. Raged on for a century, many lives were claimed, but eventually the champion stood. The rest saw their better, Mr. Rogers in a bloodstained sweater.
This is the ultimate showdown, ultimate destiny. Good guys, bad guys, and explosions. As far as the eye can see, and only one will survive. I wonder who it will be. This is the ultimate showdown.
This is the ultimate showdown.
This is the ultimate showdown.
On the fifth stroke, the time sponsored by Kristian John Thomas Radio will be then. But until then, goodbye for now.
All right, one more. This is the Doctor Who-inspired chameleon circuit with their hit, An Awful Lot of Running.
Materialize. He looked out and said to me, run for your life. I don't know why I never thought to ask him for his name, but I really don't think he'd have told me the truth anyway. But that's okay. It's completely terrifying, but it's so, so exciting. He said I was brilliant and I could change the world. So many places I've been, there's so much more to see. We got galaxies and planets and moons, and an awful lot of running to do. Companion, he gave me a key and a phone with a signal in every galaxy. As we fell through the vortex, I felt so free. Please don't let this danger just be another dream, cause my life before you was unreasonably mundane. Never been happy.
easier, although we face death every day. I wouldn't have it any other way. It's completely terrifying, but it's so, so exciting. You said I was brilliant and I could change the world. So many places I've been, there's so much more to see. We got galaxies and planets and moons, and an awful lot of running to do.
If you just try hot wiring a fragment links and superseding the binary. It's completely terrifying, but it's so, so exciting. You said I was brilliant and I could change the world. So many places I've been, there's so much more to see. We got galaxies and planets and moons, and an awful lot of running to do.
You've just had the awesome pleasure of listening to Kristian John Thomas Radio. Who's like, Kristian John Thomas Radio.